Hello, this is Yunji Lee. I will to introduce my paper, research paper. The title is Psychological Interpretation of the Human Behavior According to Changes of External Circumstance in Atypical Space. Ultimate goal of this project is to develop a kind of some intelligence, agent intelligence. So this is part of some the whole project, whole research, and the purpose of this project to develop the agent intelligent is reacting the external the circumstance, situation change. Introductions. The purpose of this study is to examine the psychological mechanism of behavior change in response to external situation change and apply it to agent intelligence. As I told you before, this study is part of research for the development of intelligent agent technology that respond to change in external circumstance. User actions respond to change in external circumstance, and it was assumed that there was a psychological cause for this. Okay. It was also assumed that there would be a difference in the psychological change and response behavior due to change in the external circumstance because atypical space have different physical and social situation from typical official space. This is method. Method is investigation and the theoretical analysis. The behavior change of user according to change in the external condition in the architectural space was investigated in this research, and then psychological mechanism were the theoretical analyze. So theoretical analysis is kind of main method of this research paper. Okay. Background. I would like to introduce the background of this research. First, atypical spaces as about various desires for life increase. Atypical space design is increasing. Atypical buildings can give user a variety of special experience compared to existing typical building. Therefore, the ability to design atypical structures has become a very important part of architecture. So that's why the many school, the university, the teach the student, professor teach the ability to design the atypical space. The tool and also tools supporting architectural design also need to support the design process or architecture atypical building. The background is a human behavior simulation for atypical architectural design. Because of the morphological peculiarity of architectural buildings, there is a possibility that architects may sometimes overlook, ignore the user of the building, user behavior, user safety and convenience, because the architect only focus on the shapes. In order to solve this problem, research on human behavior simulation based artificial intelligence tool is in progress. Sometimes the architect only the focus on the shape, they ignore the human behavior. So that's why the human behavior simulation very needed in the design process of the architecture, atypical design. Through the previous research, it has been found that this tool help architects to improve user safety and convenience in the design process and drive more diversity. Okay. This is kind of some the examples, human behavior simulation in a typical design process. Okay. Get this image, so this is part of some a typical design, and then the agent is fully the behave in the in on it. The background, the change of external circumstance. This is figure 2. Figure 2 shows the behavior. Figure 2 shows the behavior of the users in the real or typical space. It should be noted that the user not only interact with the physical context of a typical space and others, but also interact with the change in the surrounding context. So look at this. There are some events. They make a rule, or there are some shows. They make some kind of some circle. When the rain is raining, when it's raining, rains. The user's behavior is changed. Change in external circumstances are very diverse, such as weather, fire, etc. In order to realize the user simulation in the more realistic of typical space, it is necessary to develop an intelligent agent that responds to change the various external situations. This image, the user reaction behavior to change in external circumstances in built environment. Okay. Kind of examples. Okay. Next, human behaviors reacting in the external context change in a typical space. And then human behaviors and an external context change. Physical space defined human behavior, so behavior change occur in the interaction with others. Most existing human behavior simulation technology target human behavior interact with the physical environment only. Okay, looking for figure 3, you can see how user respond to various external situation change, such as fire, rainfall, snowfall, earthquake, terrorism, and the smoke, etc. Changes in external circumstances are highly likely to cause psychological change in user, which can lead to change in the user behavior. Psychological something causes the different user behavior. That's the main idea of this research. Understanding and application of such external situation change and user psychology will be able to further advance human behavior simulation technology. In order to make the more advanced, more realistic human behavior simulation, we need to understand the psychological cause that is changes human behavior. Okay. The psychological theory of three-dimensional perception. To understand the psychological cause mechanism, we need to first understand the perception about perception, because the human behavior's process is first is perception and the recognition and the behavior. This is normal process. So that's why we need to understand first how perceive the three-dimensional or something. Okay. That is kind of some theoretical, explanations, the indirect perception and the direct perception. The usual action is an in physical space or based on the information processing of the perception and perception. Therefore, in order to psychologically understand the usual speed in the physical space, it is necessary to consider the relationship between the perception and the behavior. Okay? Mechanism of the perception, recognition, and the behavior are the treat as a very important part of psychology, and many studies are still process. One of them is about 3D, three-dimensional perception. Since humans perceive three-dimensional world based on the two-dimensional visual information, psychological investigation of this has become an important research topic in the psychology. And then the most representative psychological theories of 3D perception is indirect perception and direct perception. First, indirect perceptions. Traditionally, psychological interpretation of the human 3D perception has been centered on indirect perception theory. That is the main theory of the three-dimensional perception. Indirect perception means that human synthesize and perceive a lot of information acquired in order to perceive a three-dimensional object of space. Okay? The main idea of the indirect perception is this is three-dimensional something. The human wants a lot of information and then synthesize it and then perceive. That is kind of some main theory. This can be explained by the fact that human can take action as familiar space or object even eyes. In addition, indirect perception can be understood by being able to find the direction more easily in the surface space than you visit. Okay, memory and information, indirect perception. About in indirect perception, so human memory and then information is very important because it's two-dimensional. Eyes, some information in through eye, so is not efficient. That is background idea of the indirect perception. Okay. Opposite idea of the direct perception. Direct perception, the perception of 3D is made indirect through the incoming visual information and is frequently collect through action to achieve more accuracy 3D perception. In direct perception, the perceiver is active in exploring the contextual of the environment, seeing, feeling, smelling, tasting, hearing. The directing perceptual approach suggests that the perceiver is an active and purposeful the acquirer of information, not the past information receiver. That means we human act to acquire, to perceive something. That is kind of some active action. So that is some idea of some background idea of this theory. Direct perception is a concept that contrasts with the indirect perception, and the term direct perception is used, but it is more appropriate to express it as an ecological approach to perception. Ecological psychology emphasizes the relationship between people and environment and has a basic premise that movement is caused according to the characteristic of the environment. Therefore, ecological theory asserts that the environmental context is important, and that is different in the environmental context creates different movement of different purpose. And then summary of some of this direct perception. Direct perception background out idea is some information through to us through eyes, very very plentiful, is enough. That's background idea. Okay, the three-dimensional perception in the simulation environment. In general, it is often the thought that 3D perception is made by the method of indirect perception. As an explainable human behavior simulation in the field of architectural research. Research is often conducted based on the concept of indirect perception. Traditionally, A-star algorithm, for Dijkstra algorithm, is often used as pathfinder algorithm used in the escape simulations. When the base of perception and the behavior of space in escape simulations, the psychological background can be said to be in the line with the indirect perception. On the other hand, there are many games in which the characters appearing in the game are set to understand the space in a limited manner and perform the pathfinding as they move. Directly acquire information about space through dynamic movement, action in space, and increase understanding of the space through the feedback. I think that this can increase the realization of dynamism of the games. Okay, spatial perception and human behavior in the atypical space. Atypical space have many differences in the form from typical architectural space. It's true that user cannot familiar with this type of three-dimensional space. If the user's perception of space in a typical space is interpreted based on the indirect perception theory, it can be said that the user has a very difficult state of perception of space. This is because of sufficient information about a typical space must not be acquired. They may be similar to usual situation in the unfamiliar space. Special purchase and human behavior simulation in actual space, again, based on the theory of indirect perceptions, user will have more difficulty in the responding to space or finding direct in the typical space. Based on the direct perception theory, it can be said that the interpretation of the user's perception of a space in a typical space is not much different from the perception of the space in the typical space. Naturally, continuing action even in unfamiliar space, such as a typical space, can be seen as explain the theory of the direct perception. This is kind of some theoretical some analysis. First, human behavior according to change the external situation in the typical space. First, we need to understand affordance to understand the perception and behavior. Affordances. In order to psychologically interpret the response behavior to change in the external environment, it is necessary to first understand the affordance. Affordance is kind of action possibility. There's information, kind of information for the clue to the human to behave some behavior something. For example, chair, bench, and stool induce the sitting. The subject with the handle caused the animal to grab it. To say that the behavior, the evocance is perceived means that the information or the specifying the behavior evocance is available in the DJ similarity and can be detected by the appropriately coordinated perception systems. Detecting causality is simply detecting the meanings. The source of diverse experience lies in the diversity of the similarity. Gibson is very important as some psychological researcher called the process of the selecting input information attentions. Exploratory activity is this type of the attention process in search in the general. Perceivers actively search their environment for the specific purpose. And next is the visual attention. When in voluntary transfer of the attention occur due to stimulus reliance, this transfer is called attentional capture, visual attention. Attentional capture, for example, bright flash of loud sound can distract our attention from what we are doing. The fact that people spend longer looking at the things that seem inappropriate in the scene means that attention is influenced by their knowledge of the what is usually found in the scene. In the event of a small fire at the subway station, people pay attention because something inappropriate happened in the scene. Paying attention tells us what is happening in the location and also allow us to react more quickly to the anything happening in the location. Therefore, in the event of a small fire, attention has been paid to it. So, when it leads to a large fire, you can quickly react to escape. Okay. Psychological response or behavior unexpected situation. There are two kinds of some reaction. Positive change of external situation and the negative change of external situation. The user may perform the natural reaction behavior toward the place where the positive situation appears, that is simply turn the head to look and approach. Otherwise, they may ignore the contingency of the continued previous behavior. But however, negative change of external situation. Negative situational appearance can be seen as psychologically the same mechanism as a positive situation or appearance in the generating visual tension and suggesting the falsehood that induced other behavior. However, the appearance of the negative situation is different because it requires a quick judgment and active response from the users. Also, there is a difference in the proceeding toward avoiding rather than approaching the situation that emerged. The psychological response of behavior in the situation. What we are interested in here, the perception of the space in the unfamiliar space, such as unfamiliar space or the field of view covered by smoke. In such a case, it is not possible to read a special perception and methods such as suggested by the indirect perception theory. Okay. In other words, as claimed by the theory of direct perception, a reaction is made while perceiving a visual situation as spatial situation and the perception of the action or the interact by receiving the feedback accordingly. In order to acquire spatial information necessary for the escape, he will constantly act to move his gaze. They may be factors influencing the response to be able to appearance of the negative situation in such a typical space. One of them is the misunderstanding of space. Another thing is behavior to others. It is to imitate the escape behavior and the indirect of the others in a stage where the perception of the escape has not been sufficient to achieve. Also, altruistic behavior or helping others may occur in an atypical space. They are more situational and with a movement in the unfavorable to the working week, such as the slope of the curved passageway, so that possibility of the altruistic behavior is high. Okay, this is discussion. This study, changes in external situation and corresponding the behavior were considered psychologically to serve as a theoretical base of simulation technology. Through these psychological constellations, several implications for the subsequent human behavior simulation could be drawn. First, the perception of the three space is generally explained by the theory of indirect perception psychology, but the form of perception is in an atypical space often related to direct perception. Second, it can be said that perception of change in the external circumstance is the same in the positive and negative situation, but response behavior may appear different. Third, the in perception in the response to negative external situation change, psychological different aspects can be seen in the atypical space or like in the typical space. From the presented time point, several stages for the advanced human behavior simulation can be derived as follows. First, in the simulation of the human behavior in the typical space, the scope and the method of the agent, the perception are adjusted based on the theory of direct perception so that the simulation can be highly realistic. Second, according to the positive and negative change in the external situation parameters, the affected agent reaction behavior, such as the face finding, are developed and apply to the simulation. The third, it is necessary to develop an environment that can perform human behavior simulation by giving change in the external circumstance in the designed design and then the developed agent that respond in the various way. Through this, it is possible to review the performance of the user side of the giant optical space in the real time. Conclusions. That is conclusions. This study is a theoretical analysis of the psychological mechanism for the human the behavior change of the user according to the change of the external situation in atypical actual space. Also, according to the specificity of the atypical space, the difference in the response behavior to change in the external circumstance which theoretical considers. It is significant that the theoretical basis of developing advanced human behavior simulation technology in the atypical space was secured through the psychological theory. However, it is necessary to prove the effectiveness of the theory through the technology development and experiment. In addition, it is necessary to find out what effect the development system has on the article design process. Thanks for your attention.